Good morning, everybody. Save us, O Lord our God, and gather us from the nations to give thanks to your holy name and make glory and praise to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Well, welcome as always to our Eucharist this morning. Today is the first Friday of the month, as you know. And so on this day, our Mass is celebrated for all those whose names are included here on the altar list of the dead. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. And isn't it a sobering thought that one day we too would be part of that list? That's not to dishearten you or to discourage you, rather to encourage you and I to live our best as followers of Jesus Christ. Now, at the end of Mass this morning, we will have our usual prayer of the Church, our first Friday morning prayers, with the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. The benediction will conclude as usual, except that the Blessed Sacrament will remain on the altar for the duration of today until 5 o'clock this evening, as the day of prayer for vocations to the priesthood and religious life. And indeed, God will touch the hearts of many people to serve the gospel in a full life's commitment. To prepare ourselves now to celebrate our Mass, we pause for a moment as we acknowledge that we all stand in need of God's mercy and forgiveness in each of our lives. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honour you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Always be seated now as we listen to our readings from God's Word. Our first reading, if you like, is a sort of a hymn of praise to the goodness of the life of King David, and it is light on his faults and failings. And then in the Gospel this morning, we are reminded of the fickleness of the human condition when we get an account of the beheading of John the Baptist.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. As the fat is set apart from the communion sacrifice, so David was chosen out of all the sons of Israel. He played with lions as though with kids, and with bears as though with lambs of the flock. While still a boy, did he not slay the giant and relieve the people of their shame by putting out a hand to sling a stone, which brought down the arrogance of Goliath? For he called on the Lord Most High, who gives strength to his right arm, to put a mighty warrior to death and lift up the horn of his people. Hence they gave him credit for 10,000 and praised him while they blessed the Lord by offering him a crown of glory. For he massacred enemies on every side. He annihilated his foes, the Philistines, and crushed their horn to this very day. In all his activities, he gave thanks to the Holy One, the Most High, in words of glory. He put all his heart into his songs out of love for his Maker. He placed harps before the altar to make the singing sweeter with their music. He gave the feasts their splendor, the festivals their solemn pomp, causing the Lord's holy name to be praised and the sanctuary to resound from dawn. The Lord took away his sins and exalted his horn forever. He gave him a royal covenant and a glorious throne in Israel. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praised be the God who saves me.
Praised be the God who saves me.
The ways of God are perfect, the word of the Lord pure as gold. He indeed is the shield of all who make him their refuge.
Praised be the God who saves me.
Long life to the Lord, my rock. Praised be the God who saves me. I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will sing a psalm to your name.
Praised be the God who saves me.
He has given great victories to his king and shown his love for his anointed, for David and his sons forever.
Praise God who saves me.
Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who with a noble and generous heart take the word of God to themselves and yield a harvest through their perseverance. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. King Herod had heard about Jesus, since by now his name was well known. Some were saying, John the Baptist has risen from the dead, and that is why miraculous powers are at work in him. Others said, he is Elijah. Others again, he is a prophet, like the prophets we used to have. But when Herod heard this, he said, it is John whose head I cut off. He has risen from the dead. Now it was at this time Herod who had sent to have John arrested and had him chained up in prison because of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, whom he had married. For John had told Herod, it is against the law for you to have your brother's wife. As for Herodias, she was furious with him and wanted to kill him. But she was not able to, because Herod was afraid of John, knowing him to be a good and holy man, and gave him his protection. When he had heard him speak, he was greatly perplexed, and yet he liked to listen to him. An opportunity came on Herod's birthday, when he gave a banquet for the nobles of his court, for his many officers and for the leading figures in Galilee. When the daughter of this Herodias came in and danced, she delighted Herod and his guests. And so the king said to the girl, ask me anything you like and I will give it to you. And he swore her an oath, I will give you anything you ask, even half my kingdom. She went out and said to her mother, what shall I ask for? And she replied, the head of John the Baptist. The girl hurried straight back to the king and made her request. I want you to give me John the Baptist's head here and now on a dish. The king was deeply distressed, but thinking of the oaths he had sworn and of his guests, he was reluctant to break his word to her. And so the king at once sent one of his bodyguards with orders to bring John's head. The man went off and beheaded him in prison. Then he brought the head on a dish and gave it to the girl, and the girl gave it to her mother. When John's disciples heard about this, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. And this is the Gospel of the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. It is the fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who was so humble as to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. It is the fruit of the vine and the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away our iniquities and cleanse us from all our sins. Let us now pray, my sisters and brothers, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with the angels and saints and the whole company of heaven, we too praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Dermot our Bishop, and all the clergy, the religious, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, particularly all those whose names are included here on the altar list of the dead. Welcome them and all those who have died into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. So now we unite all our prayers and our many intentions together as we pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with each one of you. So let us take a moment now to offer each other a sign of that peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death give life to the world, free us by this, your most holy body and blood, from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us always faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep all of us safe for eternal life.
that to fun. Let your face shine in your servant. Save me in your merciful love. O Lord, let me never be put to shame, for I call on you.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, through faith, may ever increase. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is now ended, so we go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. And now our prayer will follow firstly with the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. Thanks, Philip. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O Lord, open my lips. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. And now we join in the hymn, Holy God, we praise thy name.
God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee, all on earth thy scepter clip, all in heaven above adore thee. Endless is thy vast domain.
Sing a new psalm to the Lord, for he has worked wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have brought salvation. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout to the Lord, all the earth, ring out your joy. Let the sea and all within it thunder, the world and all its peoples. Let the rivers clap their hands, and the hills ring out their joy. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I will thank the Lord with all my heart in the meeting of the just and their assembly. Great are the works of the Lord, to be pondered by all who love them. He gives food to those who fear him, keeps his covenant ever in mind. He has shown his might to his people by giving them the lands of the nations. He has sent deliverance to his people and established his covenant forever. Holy his name, to be feared. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And our act of consecration to the Sacred Heart. Lord Jesus Christ, we renew today the consecration of our family to your Sacred Heart. We remember your love for us, and so we praise and thank you for all your goodness. We pledge our love in return, placing you at the centre of our hearts and of our homes. We wish to live our lives in union with you, and share your mission of love to all people. Lord Jesus Christ, accept this dedication and keep us always in your Sacred Heart. Amen.
This wonderful sacrament has left to us a memorial of thy passion. Grant us, we pray, so to venerate the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may ever perceive within ourselves the fruits of your redemption. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, part of me.